Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Kind of Life. Welcome to the channel. What we have here is the B16A Dart Max by Sisigad. For your very own, and for more information, be sure to check out the link in the description below. That's right, folks. This here is the all-new teen adult electric scooter by Sisigad. This is the B16A Dart Max. Now, I gotta say, I like the overall design on this thing. Very simplistic design, aluminum body, so it makes it very lightweight. On a full charge, expect to get about 30 miles on the full range, and it does about 19 miles per hour top speed. So with that being said, let's go ahead and take a closer look at this and then take it around town and show you guys what it's all about.
Before we begin, I do want to talk about how the scooter arrived. Came very well packaged, and the assembly was super easy. All you had to do was unfold and lock it in place. Only the handlebar needed assembly. And that was it.
So let's go ahead and take a closer look at this scooter right here. I do like the whole simplistic design. It's got an aluminum frame, so it's very lightweight. Now the tires got 10-inch fat tires on this that are very nice, especially when you go over bumps and whatnot. The platform itself is pretty wide, so it's easy to ride. And you got braking system, ABS on this thing. You got a one-step folding design. So if you're carrying this around with you, traveling with it, very easy to open up and fold over and carry it with you. Got a little shield on the back so you're not throwing any rock chips behind you. Brake light as well. Headlight, very powerful headlight on this thing. We'll show you guys that as well. And then looking on top here, you got the accelerator. That's the throttle. And to turn it on, all you gotta do is hold the power button for a couple of seconds and it lights right up. Very bright and vibrant display on this. So it shows you your miles per hour, your odometer, how many miles on this thing. So it's zero, brand new. You got your lights already on. It's showing you that. Let's see how those look. Super bright headlights. And then the taillights too that are functional when you brake. They start to flash to let people know behind you that you're coming to a stop. So you can use the power button to toggle through the settings right here. If you press it once, it turns on and off the lights. And then when you double tap the power button, it changes the speed setting. So that's high, medium, and low, kind of showing the walking, so it's very slow, very easy to use. And then to shut it down, all you gotta do is hold the power button again for a few seconds, and it turns right off. And the handlebar itself has great grips on both sides. So yeah, with that being said, let's go ahead and hop on and take this for a ride. All right, so let's go ahead and start on the slowest setting here. So this is low mode, 4 miles per hour. Let's go ahead and speed it up. Medium. Yeah, you can see it picking up speed already. So about 13 miles an hour on full speed. Let's take it up a notch, high. So this should be maximum speed on this thing. So hitting about 15 miles an hour. Kind of slowing down at about 16 miles an hour. Now wind and weight probably has a lot to do with it. I might be a little on the heavier side. I'm just trying to reach in at 17 there. So it does get up there. Maybe if I was a little bit lighter. Yeah, there you go, 18, it does max out. So check out the brakes. Now you could tighten the brakes up a little bit. A little soft there, but they do work nonetheless. All right. So just to give you guys an idea, I'm gonna show you guys how much foot room there is. So as you can see, not terrible. Does really well on turning too. Check the brakes out again. Yeah, I mean the brakes are a little soft, but they do work. Let's go again. So starting off with level high speed. See how long it takes to get up to top speed. It's a gradual increase. Slowly getting up there. Yeah, so it takes a little bit to get up to 19 miles an hour, but 17, 16, easily doable. I gotta say, it's very easy to ride. No complications whatsoever. Overall, I gotta say, it's a very smooth scooter all around. It's not bad for touring around getting from A to B. Try it on sidewalk. Maybe on some grass too. See how it does. Yeah, it's a little bumpy on the sidewalk, but it's doing pretty well. Handles really well too. I'm leaning far to the left and right, kind of hard to tell on the GoPro, but I am, and it's turning quite well. Just get an idea. Let's drive this on the grass. Slows down, so probably not the best option, but it does get you through it very slowly. Yeah, probably not the best option. It does slow me down, so I can't really ride this on grass. But on pavement, sidewalk, whatnot, even bumps, it's really good. And it's uphill, by the way. My grass is uphill here. Yeah, it's dying out. This does have cruise control too. So once you get to a desired speed, you can go ahead and just coast with it. It'll keep that speedometer going. I like how you can see how much throttle I'm depressing too. So when you accelerate all the way, all the blue bars light up. If I'm halfway, it kind of gives you an idea how much I'm depressing it. I mean, overall, I gotta say, it's a pretty nice scooter. No complaints with it whatsoever. Rides well, does what it's supposed to do. Very lightweight, which is a huge added bonus. You can keep this with you, travel around with it. Makes it very easy to use. Well, there you folks have it, the B16A Dart Max by Sisigad. If you guys have any questions about this scooter or anything else they sell, be sure to put it in the comments below. Otherwise, thanks for watching, guys.